joining us here today in Charlotte, North Carolina for the final round of the Wells Fargo Championship. Frank, what do we have out here today?
Well, if history has a chance of repeating itself, remember those great closing rounds by Rory McIlroy, that 62, that was one of the best rounds ever shot that year back in 2010. And of course that playoff too, Ricky Fowler back in 2012, where actually beat out then world number one Rory McIlroy with that stunning drive down the finishing hole and brilliant wedge to a tight flag. This golf course, it can give it, they can take it away, but for us, from where we're sitting, Rich, we'll enjoy the view today.
No doubt about it. Frank, what's so compelling about rivalries in sports is that athletes need each other if they're going to go to great heights. Joe Frazier needed Muhammad Ali to solidify his legend. Jack Nicklaus probably needed Arnold Palmer to go to.
Solid strike, right in the heart of the green.
Wow, Frank, he is dialed in.
Yeah, that was just some shot on that.
Taking it up here at the second hole, Frank, it's a short par three.
Yeah, it's placed a little bit downhill, about half a club reach. Sort of shallow bunker in that back area. Also, that green starts to reduce in size on the left side.
Greg, there's a lot to chew on here as you get to the tee at the 532-yard par 5-7.
In today's game, 530-plus change, you think is incredibly short. And look at the trouble. Strong three. kicks down and towards the left, and it sounds like it's worth the risk.
Well,